Hey everybody, it's Jasmine. So I wanted to do a quick video talking about how I maintain my itchy scalp and dandruff. I have a few tips and tricks here, and I know I mention a lot on my channel about my journey and struggle to find products that really work for my scalp, and you guys have actually really helped along the way. So I wanted to make this video because I do get questions quite often. What do I use? What are the methods? And I just wanted it to all be in one video. I have heard that dandruff is hereditary, but I am not sure if that is true or not. But I do know that my dad does have dandruff, and we pretty much kind of have the same hair care routine, which is kind of funny. So my dad has really bad dandruff, and I want to say like I am more like moderate. I know how to contain it a little bit more than my dad. My dad, you know, he's a guy, so sometimes he doesn't want to do his whole hair care routine, which is fine. I respect that, it's okay. And also, I heard dandruff is also caused via fungus. If you think about it, some of us, we shower, we let our hair dry naturally, but sometimes the environment that we're in, our hair doesn't completely dry. So for example, I would take a shower at night, but I wouldn't let my hair air dry before I go into my bed. So my hair is sopping wet, and then I go and lay down, and now my hair has soaked my pillow. My pillow is now moist, and that moisture just sits there all night, and then sometimes I'll wake up and my hair is not dry. And then lo and behold, the whole entire day my head is itchy. So there are definitely factors that will contribute to having an itchy scalp or dandruff and things of that nature. So I want to start off with shampoo and conditioner because I have gone through so many bottles, and I found that having intense fragrances or a lot of artificial fragrances really irritate and dry out my scalp. So I've resulted into finding shampoo and conditioners with either tea tree or peppermint. Now, although they don't have a strong fragrance, the peppermint and tea tree will actually just make my hair smell fresh as opposed to floral, which is fine. I like that. So the ones that I am currently using is by the brand Acure. I got this one from TJ Maxx, but I also saw this sold at Target too, so it's widely available. Now, I have the one that is the Vivacious Volume Peppermint and Echinacea. I'm not an English major for a reason, but it's the peppermint one, and I find that this is probably the best shampoo and conditioner I found for my hair at a very affordable price. Now, not only does this not irritate my scalp, but it's also vegan, sulfate-free, paraben-free, and cruelty-free. So if you have dyed hair, this is sulfate-free, so it's not going to wash out your color. That's amazing. It just knocks off so many points, and I just feel like this is a brand that a lot of people overlook. I do have to say it's a little expensive for what it is. I think at Target it might be like $10 a bottle. At TJ Maxx I only paid $5.99 per bottle, which I don't mind. I'd rather pay a little bit extra for something that I know will work as opposed to just buying something cheap and then I will have to just live with the dandruff. Now, for the longest time, I always felt like my hair was just super, super dry. There was never a conditioner nourishing enough for me, so I would always have to use either a hair mask or a deep conditioner as a regular conditioner. So I always recommend finding something of that nature. So the ones that I use right now, I have a tea tree oil one. You can get this from Shop Miss A or any beauty supply store. This is from the brand Sunflower Mega Care. This is their tea tree oil premium hair mask. This helps prevent dry and itchy scalp. Tea tree and peppermint are just a really good agent in any skincare routine simply because it kind of clears the skin and also helps protect it. So a lot of the times you will see tea tree products for dandruff, you'll see it for acne, itchy skin, anything of that nature. It pretty much just helps maintain that area. So tea tree, big, and peppermint, big. I want you guys to take that away from this video. But also for the ends of my hair, sometimes I just feel like, you know, maybe I don't need all that peppermint, I don't need all that tea tree. So I have one of these guys. Now this is a hair mask. This is from the brand OGX. This is the Damage Remedy Coconut Miracle Oil Hair Mask. I use it as a regular conditioner because sometimes the Acure one isn't enough and, you know, my hair just gets dry way too fast. The climate also plays a huge part in the dryness of your scalp as well. You know, we are getting into the drier months, so you probably will start seeing your hair, you know, get a little salty flakes in there, if you will. And it's mostly really, really noticeable if you have black hair. So if you want to prevent that and you want to exfoliate that area, I always recommend a scalp scrub. Yes! These are available. I only found this out maybe a year ago that these were a thing. This one is by Not Your Mother's. This is actually one of their newer releases. They launched this, I think, last winter. So it's still really new to their line. This is their Activated Bamboo Charcoal and Purple Moonstone. This is the Restore and Reclaim Scalp Scrub. So you want to go ahead and wet your hair in the shower, and then you want to take the scrub as much as you need, and then you want to really get up in there. They actually do make like a scalp brush for the shower, but if you have like a regular hairbrush that you want to take in the shower or even use your hands, feel free. I mean, as long as you know like you're really getting it in there and you're really scrubbing, that's all that matters. Now, I do have to say scalp scrubs are really tricky because if you don't fully rinse your hair, the exfoliants will stay in there. This is cruelty-free. It's really affordable. It's less than $10 and these always go on sale at Ulta. So there will be no problem with you finding this. I don't know if you guys remember 2 years ago when I was raving about Head & Shoulders and their scalp spray. Soon to find out, not only were they testing on animals, but they were already discontinuing the product. So I had to find something that was cruelty-free and that will also do the same job. I've gone through scalp sprays after scalp sprays, high-end, low-end, and I found this one. This one is by Palmer's. This is their Coconut Oil Strong Root Spray. Now, I like this because I feel like it refreshes the scalp. It has a little bit of that minty feeling on the scalp, so very similar to what peppermint kind of gives me. And if you don't have anything peppermint infused and you do have just a regular scalp spray, you can actually just buy the oils. So these ones are from Shop Misset. You can get some at your local grocery stores if you want. I would recommend for a bottle this size that you would do maybe 4 drops of oil in here. Anything less, you would have to, you know, go accordingly. You don't want to add too much peppermint. You don't want to add too much tea tree because you don't want it to be too strong on the skin. But I find when I use this, my scalp just feels very fresh and very clean. This one does take a little longer to dry as opposed to the Head & Shoulders one, but it is a great, great alternative and it's really affordable. You can find it at Target. Recently, I've been blow drying my hair, which is super new to me because I was always that person that was like, I don't want to apply heat on my hair if it's unnecessary, but I found that blow drying my hair actually helps my dandruff, and it's because I am not letting the fungus grow on my hair because, like I said, the pillow incident, you're not letting that fungus grow. So this is the blow dryer that I use. I have had this since I was in elementary school, which I think it's kind of cool. This is by Vidal Sassoon, and this is their Eco Style, which I think is so cool since we're in like an eco-friendly environment right now. Yeah, so this is a blow dryer that if you still have it plugged into the wall, it's not going to conduct electricity until you turn it on. Now it says on here, it says, did you know appliances that are off but plugged in are still consuming energy? This one doesn't do that. So this one saves energy and you could still have it plugged in. It's great. I love that for them. And because we are talking about blow drying the hair, let's talk about a little bit of styling products. I have this little sample of R & Co's High Dye. This is their Moisture and Shine Cream. I find that when I apply this right before I blow dry my hair just looks so soft and silky. So I'll apply this more on the ends and then I'll take the rest up near the roots. And I just find that my hair just cooperates so much better. I did blow dry my hair last night and my hair just always looks and feels so, so good. Now, if I were to, say, curl or straighten my hair, then I would take some argan oil. This one is by Moroccan Oil. Same thing. I really like this stuff because it's a natural heat protectant and you could find it anywhere, whether it is the expensive Moroccan oil or if you go to a beauty supply store and buy the $5 one. It doesn't matter, it all works the same. And I just feel like it's an oil, so it'll give you soft, silky, smooth hair. And you know, sometimes you're out in the sun and you never know if your hair is going to be soaking up that heat. So you want to just make sure you protect it with something. And just like that, those are my personal tips on how I deal with my itchy scalp and dandruff. Of course, this may not work for you, but it definitely does work for me, and it has been working for a couple of months now, and I can truly say that this is my regimen. This is something that I look for. I may not always buy the Acure brand, but I'm always looking for peppermint shampoo and conditioner. So think about that next time you are looking for some products. This isn't the only scalp scrub on the market. This isn't the only hair mask on the market. You know, you can pick and choose, but you know, I wanted to give you guys a guideline of where I'm at. So I hope you guys all enjoy this video. I hope it was really informative, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. Peace out, Girl Scouts.